With so much talk about RMR capsules in cases recently, I feel like the items from the three new Broken Fang collections have been heavily underlooked. So today, we're going to take a deep dive into why I think a potential really good investment could be in these three collections. And you get to use them as play skins at the same time if you do think the same as me. So if you're new to the channel and in the 85% of people that watch my videos and still aren't subscribed, as per usual, be sure to sub so you don't miss any of my investing content. And really quickly, before we get into the video, let's talk about today's sponsor, once again, Luckbox. Luckbox is the first EGR award-winning betting site and one of, if not the most secure betting sites out there. You can bet on Dota, League, CSGO of course, and much, much more. And there's a ton of different options as well. You can bet on the correct score of the match, who will win which maps, round advantage, and much more. And best of all, you can use code SUKA120 for a 120% deposit bonus. So be sure to sign up using the link at the top of the description and put your esports knowledge to use. But for now, let's get into the video. So first of all, why do I think items from the new Operation Broken Fang collections are a good investment? Well, because personally, I think they're going to be the exact same situation as the three collections from Shattered Web. Meaning, first of all, they seem to be discontinued and potentially we could never see them in the game again, making the items in them obviously extremely limited. But even if they are added again in the future, there would have been a huge profit if you bought in during the operation. So let's take a deeper look at the specifics. Specifically first, the Wild Lotus, the AK Wild Lotus, which hovered around the $250 range at the beginning of the operation when people really didn't know what to sell it at. And as the operation went on, it eventually ended at around the $550 range when the operation ended on March 30th. So towards October, many months passed for the operation to be gone. It was hovering around the $800 to $900 range as people are buying it up. There's no way to get it anymore besides trade-ups, and it's just a rare item. So pretty good profit if you just hold it. But then if we look at the past price from December 3rd on, which specifically December 3rd is the date Operation Broken Fang along with the three new collections got released. This thing spikes up to like $1,100, and this is just on the Steam market. Considering this item is a red and super limited, it's kind of hard to get an exact price trend on it. It's kind of always up and down. As we'll get into later in the video, we'll look over a purple skin where the price trend is a lot more, I guess, sharp, you can say, where you could actually see the thing moving up and down and how the trend actually makes a lot more sense because there's a lot more items in circulation because it's a purple compared to a red. But we'll get more into that in a bit. So just to further the point for now, the Mag 7 quesadilla, I don't know how you call this thing. However you pronounce it, it was also from one of the Shattered Web collections. It also had a $150 price spike from December 3rd. So when people realized these collections weren't going to be used again, at least in the next operation, they were super limited. So these items are super limited, and as people realize that, they're going to shoot up in price. So am I saying that we're going to see the same exact trend with items in the Broken Fang collections? Well, probably not the exact same, but maybe something similar. Of course, it is still an investment and not just guaranteed profit, but I don't see why CSGO devs would take a one operation hiatus of not reusing the collections just to reuse them again for Broken Fang only and just kind of skip over Shattered Web, if that makes sense. It wouldn't really make sense in the grand scheme of things and potentially would mess up the market, and I'm sure they would be well aware that that would happen, but we're dealing with our good old friends at Valve, the same people that added the R8 revolver to the game and made it a one-shot weapon all those years ago. Never forget, but that's getting a bit off topic, I don't want to dig into Valve too much, but they seem to care about money a lot, so maybe they'll think about this one a bit differently. So some things to keep in mind is that all of these skins, except obviously the reds, can be used as trade-ups, so they can be traded up to their higher tier skin. Purples to pinks, pinks to reds, blues to purples, all that good stuff. So even if they don't look that great to people, there's still going to be people buying them. So if you feel like this is a good investment, but you don't have the budget for an op fade or something, that's always on the table. You don't have to buy a red skin or a pink skin. Purples are still there. I don't want to make this video an hour long by showing you every single price trend of the pinks, purples, and all that from the Shattered Web collections, but if we look at the P90 Astro somebody told me how to pronounce this and I don't remember, so Jormungandr, I'm gonna say that. The price trend is a lot sharper. With so many more being sold and so many more in circulation, don't just think that you don't have enough for pinks and reds, so you're going to be stuck with a bad investment like a purple. As you could see, these things are good investments as well. I guess people are buying them for trade-ups, which is why they're going up so much, or people just like the skin, even though it's not that great, and a P90, but who knows, it's going up. It makes sense because it's super limited, and we could potentially see this again in Operation Broken Fang. Those are the three main things you have to realize. So overall, although I'm not saying the RMR stickers, operation cases, and all the other stuff I've talked about in the past couple of weeks are bad investments, I'm not saying that at all. This is just another thing to add to the list of potential things that you might want to get in on. But of course, keep in mind that Valve might just make a weird decision, unlike Shattered Web, to re-add the collections in the game eventually. So just keep your eyes out on your investments. Of course, there is going to be some risk, but be ready to sell if you feel the price is right. And the great thing about having a skin investment is that, of course, you can use it as a play skin while making money with it as it appreciates in price. And a lot of the operation skins are pretty sick, so it's a win-win. But as for all that, I think that does cover everything I wanted to go over in this video. So if you guys did enjoy, be sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you're new and want to watch some of my other investing videos or CSGO videos in general. But for now, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.